Hi, I'm Dave Lamson, and welcome to another episode of Dave Lamson's Do's and Don'ts. Today I've got a special guest with me, the amazing Kristen Cavanis.
Hello.
Welcome, Kristen. We're here today to make a special announcement. Kristen, would you like to do the honors?
Thank you, Dave. We are very excited to announce some major upgrades to the lesson planning process and templates in Google. And we are very excited that this whole program was designed with continuous improvement in mind so that we have the power over the design so we can listen to your feedback, take it in, and continuously make it better and better for you.
We received a lot of feedback throughout the semester, some of it good, some of it needing improvement. And the number one item that we saw to make improvements to the system was the speed of how fast the lesson templates ran. We spent the entire semester focusing on ways to improve that and actually worked with Google to make some changes in how it functions, and we'd like to show that to you today. So I'm gonna go to my computer, and I'm gonna go to Google Drive, and I'm gonna scroll down on here, and I'm gonna pick New Lesson Plan Template. The first thing that you're going to notice is a new teacher profile page. Kristen, would you like to tell us a little bit more about that?
In our previous planner setup, your planner was continuously importing from an outside database. So now you have a profile where you can pick the courses that you teach and the standards that you actually need and just import those into your planner one time.
All right, so let me show you another option down here too, just something to be aware of. Way off on the right-hand side, there's three tabs. These three tabs, when you first come in, they're going to be empty. They're highlighted in orange, and we want you to leave those alone. Those three tabs really drive this lesson plan template. Back onto the teacher profile, you're going to notice a button right here that says Import Content Areas. How many content areas and grade courses do you think we have?
About 270.
270, and each of those have tons of standards behind them. How many standards are there?
We're working about 200,000 rows of standards.
200,000 rows. So on the last lesson plan template, every time you opened it, the template would go out to Google and it would re-download those standards into your planner. On the new version, when you click this button, it's going to download all of the available content areas and grade courses, but not the standards. So let's show you how this works. I'm going to go back to the template and I'm going to click Import Content Areas. This is a button, so I'm going to click it. And when I do, you'll notice at the top it says Running Script, and it gives you a Cancel button or a Dismiss button. Don't click Dismiss. When the script is done, it's going to give you this pop-up that says Content Areas and Grade Courses in your Profile tab have been updated. Be sure to review Column C for the courses you teach. You'll click OK on that tab. You'll notice that I get a last update with a date and time. And then down here, it's showing all of the available content areas and grade courses that are available for you to choose from. Kristen, what kind of teacher do you want to be today?
I feel like teaching kindergarten today, Dave.
Kindergarten, great. I've got a kindergartner in school. So in order to tell the planner that you teach kindergarten, you'll go ahead and you'll pick those content areas and grade courses. So luckily, kindergarten's right at the top, and you'll just put an X inside the column for those courses. Do you want to teach social studies as well? Let's pick up social studies.
I definitely want to teach social studies.
So after selecting those courses, the next thing that you need to do is go ahead and import the standards. So we've picked our courses. Now I'm going to come up here and I'm going to click Import Standards. It gives you a pop-up right away that says this script is dependent on how many grade courses that you selected. In this case, we only picked 5, and I think in all of kindergarten, there's a little less than 400 standards. So when I say OK, again at the top, it tells me running script. Don't click dismiss, just let that finish. And when the process is done, you're going to get a date and time right here.
And what's really cool about this is we always know the last time you imported standards. So if we ever do have changes, we know we have new ELAR standards coming soon. You'll just be able to hit that re-import button at any time. If you need to add courses that you didn't think about your first time, you can always come back to your profile and change what courses you're importing into your planner.
So I got the pop-up here that tells me that the script is done. So I'll go ahead and it says my template standards have been updated. And I'm going to click OK. When I do, it gives me the date and time that that was last imported. So like Kristen was saying, you can always look at that and go, wow, I haven't updated my standards. Maybe in a couple weeks, it might be a good time to do that every once in a while.
And that waiting, the spinning some of you may have experienced when using your standards, only happens at this initial import. After this, your standards are pasted into your planner, and they're just there. There's no more waiting or looking outside every time you need to plan.
So let me show you what that did. After we imported the standards, now those three tabs off to the right, there's a content area loaded. It only says kindergarten. There's grade courses loaded. It's the content area and grade courses that I selected, and the standards have been loaded into my planner. And I believe there's a little less than 400, about 300, oh, there we go, 388 kindergarten curriculum standards.
That's a whole lot less data than 200,000,
Dave. A lot less. And every time you open your planner, these are already here. Like Kristen said, we're not having to go out and re-download them again. They're already loaded. So let's show you how fast this makes your planner. What subject do we want to teach today?
Let's teach social studies, Dave.
Social studies, all right. So we're going to jump into social studies workshop. You want to talk about some of the changes we made here?
Sure. One thing that's really exciting to me is to be able to give you a standard selector on every tab. So there were some restrictions with the previous setup, but now you can duplicate tabs endlessly. No matter what, you will have your standard selector right there on your same tab, and it stays put as you scroll. So I'm just gonna go ahead and select my kindergarten social studies, and notice how it happens instantly, because again, we're not looking to an outside database any longer. I can come in and my standards immediately populate. I can even come in, if I know I'm teaching 5B, I can just start typing 5B and narrow down that dropdown that comes in. I might even know that what I'm teaching has to do with geography. I can start typing the word, and it'll narrow my standards list down to things with that word in it. So that can help you really use your standards much more quickly, much more efficiently. We really went on a personal mission to see, can we resolve every issue that has been experienced and submitted through our feedback form? So we've heard a lot about how the drop-down menu when you are on Friday sometimes get cut off on the right side of your screen. So we've even added some extra space off to the right just to give that room to load. You might notice something when you see my standards pop open that is also new. We've been able to move every single standards number to the beginning. Once again, just to help you spot that standard you're looking for even faster. Some other changes that will help you a lot and you don't really need to bore yourself with the details over is just the programming in the background on each of your tabs. When you're copying and pasting between tabs now, you won't break that standards connection because again, every tab has that same programming behind it.
So another cool feature is they can actually copy one of these tabs down here, click on any tab and choose duplicate. And that's gonna make a copy inside my planner of that tab. And I can pick different content areas and grade courses. So an example is if you're in secondary and you're teaching geography, you can pick different standards for geography as you do from like world history, or my wife taught AP US history, AP A-push. And she could have different tabs for each of those courses and select different standards very easily without having to go back and forth to a standards selector.
And what's great is now when you set up your planner initially, each tab you'll indicate which courses you want access to, and then you don't have to switch that unless you just need to. You can always access any standards that you want, but for the most part, you won't have to be switching back and forth to get to your standards anymore.
So finally, we do want to point out that none of these changes would have been made without your feedback. We still have a feedback form on here. We encourage you, even with this version, to continue to submit feedback, to tell us other ways that we can continue to improve and to make this lesson planner the best possible tool that it can be for you in your classrooms and in your teaching.
So let's talk about what this really means to you. When you get back from the break, which we hope you have a wonderful break and don't think anything about lesson planning during that time, when you get back on January 2nd, you'll have an email from Mark Thomas with this video again, because we know you'll miss us, plus just all the instructions that you'll need. We'll be a few weeks before the fourth, 6 weeks. So the idea here is that you'll be ready to get set up for that fourth 6 weeks with the new and improved planner. If you should happen to want to go ahead and start the new planner right away, you will be welcome to. All of these new templates, as well as your simple step-by-step instructions, will be waiting for you when you return January 2nd.
Anything else?
I think that's about it. We wish you Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, enjoy your break.
We hope you enjoyed this episode of Dave Lamson's Do's and Don'ts with special guest Kristen Cavanis.